Thanks a lot, Philippe, for this very nice presentation. And I will now take the opportunity to update you on what the Cholera Country Support Platform has been doing since a year. To do so, I will remind all of us how the CSP was conceived. We will speak about the accomplishment to date, the additional initiative, and how we do things, the next action to go forward. So first of all, you probably remember what was discussed a year and a half ago. The CSP, the Country Cholera Support Platform, is the operational arm of the GTFCC. And the CSP was created upon request of country to support them to implement several activities. The CSP is hosted by IFRC, and we receive some seed funding from several donors, Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, for 3 years. We have also SDC, the Swiss Agency for Development, and recently we signed a grant with the Wellcome Trust through the British Red Cross to have one extra staff to address the cholera research agenda. So in this light, the most important things to remember is the operational arm. And that has a strong impact on our work. When the CSP was sought, we designed 3 main outcomes that the CSP should deliver. The outcome one is about the National Cholera Plan. And the CSP is supporting this process in several countries. When we say supporting, we have 2 obsessions, I would say, multi-sectorial and operational. And I will develop what does that mean for us in the coming slide. The second outcome is the resource mobilization and the advocacy. And here we have 2 angles. The global level for advocacy and resource mobilization, but also the country level. We need to support the country to increase their advocacy activities and to increase also the resource mobilization at country done by the country. The third outcome, it's about multi-sectoral technical support, capacity building, and deployment of expertise of consultants in the cholera-affected countries. Oh, sorry, I come back. On top of that, we have several activities, and the CSP is strongly engaged in some pillars, such as OCV and WASH, and I will develop that later on. What we don't do, I have briefly mentioned what we are doing, but we have our own limitation. For example, the CSP cannot provide direct funds to countries to take some WASH action or OCV action. We are not designed for that, and it's not our mandate. Also, the CSP cannot provide long-term human resource in a country. For example, it had happened in the past that we were asked to provide 1 staff 1 year in the Ministry of Health or WASH, Ministry of Water in a certain country. We cannot do that. We can send some consultant for a specific objective with a specific expertise, but other than that, it's difficult for us. And the CSP is not a first-time responder for cholera emergency and cannot provide logistic support for cholera emergency. Again, it's not our mandate and we are not designed for that. Additionally, the CSP doesn't lead strategic decisions. IFRC is part of the GTFCC steering committee, but not the CSP. Also, the CSP is not leading any technical working group. We are part of all of them, but we are not leaders. We are the arm, not the head. And the CSP, it's not here to replace the existing mechanism. At the global level or at country level, this is why we have the CSP project manager in the country to make sure that we are able to fully tailor-made our action to the countries. So now, let's discuss a bit about the accomplishment to date. As you remember, there was an inception period, initially for 6 months, who was extended to 10 months. This extension was basically due to some delay in the recruitment process. What happened when we were created? We had to establish a new model of operation for us. We seen IFRC mechanism in relation with the country, in relation with the GTFCC, and of course, in relation with all the stakeholders. And this is true for HR, admin, logistics, finance, everything. And that took a bit of time. And it's not finished. We are almost doing that on a daily basis where we need to implement our protocol, our SOP, to make sure that we can provide the good support to the country. If I talk now about the team and the coordination, I would say that by 2021, by end of 2021, the CSP had 7 out of 8 staff deployed. And we were missing one who finally was who arrived in Bangladesh in March 2022. And now we have the CSP operational in Bangladesh, Zambia, Nigeria, and DRC. To maintain the project and the full coordination, we have almost a daily call with the GTFCC Secretariat or with the WHO team. We have regular call with, of course, the donor and many stakeholders, and of course, with the country. It's very important to be sure that the CSP is fully integrated in a process that is already existing and that we don't reinvent the wheel. So this coordination is fundamental for us. But again, to do that, we need to develop our standard operating procedure, our process, our guideline, and so on. The main challenge we had to face in a year, it's first the delay in recruitment. It took some time for us to recruit the person and to deploy them in the country, but also in Geneva. Also, the CSP is new. We had to build trust. We are small, but we are new. So we had to discuss with a lot of stakeholders to be, how can I say, to make sure that we are not seen as a competitor, but we are seen as a partner. And that's our core activity. Additionally, and I will mention that later on, the CSP has been doing a lot of effort to set up some tools, some procedures, some toolkit to make sure that we can operationalize all our action for NCP, but also for the other pillar. After a year of existence, because our first staff started in May 2021, we are now in a period where we will adapt the CSP to the new challenge, starting by HR changes. So the only things to remember from this slide is that the CSP is building the ship while it's sailing it. It's literally, and that's fascinating because with you, we think we can do it. So that's a small example of the change where we are going to. This organigram will be implemented very soon. So as you see in the red square, we have our CSP project manager. So Joseph, maybe you can raise your hand, who is based in Zambia. We have Desiré, who is based in Congo. We have Abhishek, who is based in Bangladesh. And unfortunately, Abel could not join here. He's based in Nigeria. In addition, at the central level, we have Annika Venland, who is here and who is working on the National Cholera Plan. Jane, here, working on resource mobilization and advocacy. And we have someone else based in Nairobi, Anne-Sophie Porsche, who is working on technical support and capacity building with the country. And very soon, we will have flying, roving NCP OCV staff, because it's really two areas where we want the CSP to gear up, and this person will be based in Brazzaville. We will have the cholera research person who will be recruited in the next few weeks. This person will be based in London in the office of the British Red Cross with the support of Wellcome Trust. And we will finally have one admin person in Brazzaville to update us with the day-to-day work because the team is getting bigger. So as I told you, we are physically present in Nigeria, DRC, Zambia, and Bangladesh, but it's not the only country we are supporting. Through consultancy activity for OCV, for WASH, and so on, we have been supporting extra countries. So here you have the list. I will just mention the last line, the OCV consultancy in Pakistan. This mission is sponsored and supported by WHO, but the CSP has managed to support the training of these persons. So that shows the total complementarity between the CSP and the GTFCC, especially for rapid deployment of expertise. If I come back on the outcome one and the national cholera plan, of course, we are supporting the country to make their plan operational and multi-sectorial, but we are also supporting the country around this activity. For example, strengthening the country cholera task force, which is a mandatory step. Without a strong task force at the country level, nothing can be done. We are facilitating also some workshops at the country level to make sure that the six pillars and all the partners are put in the loop and will contribute to the national cholera plan. And we are developing other tools that are fundamental for the country and for the partner, such as a stakeholder mapping, milestone, timelines, activities, and so on, basically. And this is a way to become operational for us. Indeed, if we want to go from the global level, the global framework, to the national operational framework, there is a lot of factions that the country, the partner, and the CSP must do. And there is also some condition. The first one is the commitment of the country. And it's the mandatory step. Without this commitment, without the engagement of the country, it's impossible to start an NCP. And we need also the engagement of partners and the commitment of donors. Philippe said that it's strongly needed for all the pillars, especially for the WASH, and it's something that we see every day. When we do a national cholera plan, there is two approaches, two angles that go in parallel, the strategy component and the operational component. As an example, at the country level, the strategy component is the identification of target, of milestone. It's basically where do we want to be by 2030 to eliminate cholera and where we are now. And the operationalization of this process is to set up the objective, the timeline, the monitoring and evaluation system, who will allow the country to progress over the time. And that takes quite some time to implement. But this is the only way, at the end of the day, to have an NCP that really serves the cholera elimination, an NCP that can support advocacy, can support resource mobilization and coordination. If I take the example of workshop, we did recently a workshop in Nigeria 2 weeks ago, and before we managed to organize a series of workshops in DRC and Zambia. I would like to bring additional information on this workshop because they are fundamental for us. A workshop is not really the kickoff of the process because the process can start even before when we prepare the workshop, when the hotspot analysis are done. But it's really the formalization on who does what in the country, pillar by pillar, with some deadline, with some deliverable, to make sure that we will have an NCP. The NCP can take 6 months, a year sometimes. It really depends on the country. The countries are different level. There are some countries where there is a high centralization and some countries where there is a high decentralization. All this organization has to be taken into account. And this is the workshop, is the moment where we prepare all that. It's the moment when we do the SWOT analysis. It's the moment when we do the capacity analysis, the gap analysis. Everything is done at this level, and after we have few months to develop what we want to develop to reach a plan that is implementable for the next 5 years. So here you have an example about the workshop, some screenshot. It's a lot of people, They have all been extremely dynamic. There is a lot of enthusiasm from the country and from the partner. And this is quite nice, actually, to see all this enthusiasm and this energy. And on this slide, you have example of output, term of reference, Gantt chart, pillar by pillar, deliverable, pillar by pillar, SOP, and so on. And this is a strong process we promote to make sure that we will reach our point. And this is, again, another example of output when we do a workshop, a stakeholder mapping. Who does what for cholera in a certain country? And of course, this is extremely important. When we do that, by the end of the day, we have four countries, we have plenty of Excel everywhere with many name, address, and so on. And this is just the beginning. Now we need to share that, we need to consolidate that, of course, with the GTFCC partner, with the Health and Wash cluster, and ideally, if we can have a partner who can help us to have a proper platform, user-friendly, to have all these organization names when we want to act in a country, that would be wonderful. So here, it's a call for help. And I will continue my call for help. I was saying that for the NCP, we need several little projects, several tools, toolkit, toolbox. We don't care the way we call it. But we need, for example, to develop an NCP situation analysis methodology, maybe an NCP situation analysis tool, and probably an NCP situation analysis training. And we have this for many other tools. For example, Philippe mentioned the IRP evaluation. It's extremely important to facilitate the life of the people who are in the IRP because they will be overwhelmed. So we have, with the GTFCC, started to set up a kind of a tool, protocol, to make sure that their life is better. And also the country asks for it. It's a fair question, valid question from a country. You ask us to do a plan that will be evaluated. Can we have a look at the criteria for evaluation? I think it's fair. So we have to do all this process. And for that, honestly, sometimes we feel a bit alone. So if we have any organization, partner, who would like also to support the CSP, the GTFCC, to help us on this project, who are transversal, they are not fully attached to one pillar, it's more than welcome. I'm done with outcome one. I don't go to the outcome two because my colleague, Marion and Jane, will speak about that just after my presentation. So I will immediately jump to the outcome three, which is capacity building. And for this outcome, in a year, the CSP has, of course, developed some tools that I've mentioned. We have developed a pool of experts for cholera. We have around 140-150 experts, I mean by pillar, for OWASH, for OCV, for NCP, and so on, with language and expertise, and that allow us to deploy them very rapidly when it's needed. So it's something that we could share also. I think it's quite interesting, and we have been deploying some experts, and I don't come back on that. I presented you that earlier. What we are also doing, we try to map all the available recent cholera trainings. It's very important that we try to not reinvent the wheel. And if a partner did need an online training on, for example, case management, it would be good if he can come back to the GTFCC and say, I need that. And we have identified two or three partners who have done that recently in English or in French and so on. So it is something that we are developing. Recently, we have been developing an actor self-assessment for cholera that has been tested with three Red Cross national societies. And that allow the partner, in this case the national society, in 2 or 3 hours to understand where they are on cholera, on some specific action, and to monitor them over the time. And of course, we have been supporting the training of OCV consultant in a wonderful, I would say, OCV training that was co-organized by WHO, CDC, MMGH, and Merieux Foundation, and I forget some other partners. So here we see some screenshot about another tool that we implemented. It's a WASH baseline tool that we piloted in Nigeria 2 months ago. And in the middle, you have a spider chart about the self-assessment tool for the National Society or any other partner when they want to know where they are about on cholera. Now, out of these three pillars, very soon we will have the cholera research senior expert that will be physically in the London office of the British Red Cross, but will be managed by the CSP. And this person's job will be to address the cholera research agenda. We have been late in the recruitment for internal and external factors. So this is my last slide almost. And this is the three takeaway message I would like to share with you. We need technical help, not only financial, of course we need, but we need technical help on all the little tools I mentioned in front of you, because it's difficult to support the countries without this tool, and we cannot do everything at the same time. So that's my first one. We need, of course, to strengthen our global and our national advocacy and resource mobilization strategy. As Philippe said, we need additional resources to continue. And also for the CSP, we need additional resources to continue after 2023, actually. So there is a strong call on that to continue to support the CSP. And finally, we are late, not only because of COVID, not only because of internal factor or external factor. We are also late because since day one, we took the decision to focus building the CSP well instead of fast. We take the time to develop some tools that can be reused from a country to another. We don't want the NCP just to be a piece of paper, actually. We want to be a very powerful tool to implement and to monitor the actions around cholera. If you want to join us, please use the country support platform, ifrc.org. And basically, that was my last slide. So I would like to thank you again. Thank you.